Hello friends, so here we have an hexagonal lamina, projection of hexagonal lamina, it's number 34. So a regular hexagonal lamina of side 30 mm is lying in such a way that one of its sides touches both the reference plane. If the lamina makes a 60 degree with the HP, draw the projection. Okay, so here they have not mentioned whether it is resting on the side or a corner. You can see one of the side touches both the reference plane, means it is resting on the side. So this is the clue where you can find the first position angle. Okay, or else you can see here, if the lamina makes a 60 degree with the HP, so lamina makes 60 degree with, means so it is resting on the HP. Okay, lamina makes a 60 degree means it is lying, it is resting on the HP. And in the third position, one of the side, that is the resting side, will touch both the reference plane. Okay, so there are two ways by which you can do this problem. Okay, it's a 30 mm hexagon. Okay, so one way is it is resting on the HP and it is inclined at a 60 degree to the HP, and at last it touches both the VP and HP, that is a reference plane. Okay, so that is one edge. Right, so that's a one way. Okay, so normally we have done the problems related to like this. It is resting on HP, so inclined to the HP and touches to the both the reference plane. So that we'll talk once we solve this difficult method. Okay, so we have one more method by which you can solve this one very easily. Okay, so that method we'll see. So just to start with that, so we'll take one XY. Okay, so we'll write this VP and HP. Okay, so here we'll not take this one. Normally we take a resting on HP means from here. Okay, so we'll start from the top itself. Okay, a typical way. So the side is 30, so what we'll do, we'll take a radius equal to 30. Okay, so then we'll draw up a simple line at 30. Okay, just we'll drop one circle. Okay, so now it is we'll drop one origin operation. So now the side should be on the XY line. So for that one, we'll take from the, okay, so let us this XY line for a time being. Okay, so we'll finish up this hexagon. So once this one is done, so we'll drop the XY line. Okay, so we'll write this is XY, this is VPHP. Okay, so we'll write this is A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay, this is a small correction in that one. Okay, because if you draw that XY line, it's difficult to go with the circle method. So we'll just erase that one, and once we construct this one, we'll draw XY line passing through this edge. So now drop it upward and do the dimension. This is a 30. Okay, so now we'll draw X1, Y1. Okay, so now just to show it to you people. Like, just we are making this one tilted like this. Okay, so for that one, what we'll do, it is inclined at 60 degrees to the HP. So first we'll take an inclination. Okay, 60 degree to the HP. Yeah. Okay, just drop a thin line. Okay, so this is the inclination of the HP. Okay, visible in the front view. So now what you have to do, you take all the projections of these lines till x1, y1. Okay, anyway, this will come here. Say, just for a name, we will write this is BC, this is A in the bracket D, and this is F in the bracket E. Okay, so once this is done, so now we'll take the arc from each point, okay, and we'll cut it on the 60 degree line. 1, 2, and this line will remain same. So now we will make this line darker till to the first arc, like this. Okay, now this line corresponds to B double dash, C double dash. So this is A double dash, D double dash, and this one is F double dash, E double dash. Okay, so now you have to take these projections reverse. Like this. Okay, so now from each point you just drop a vertical projection. 1, 2, 3, and 4, because these lines will remain same here itself. Okay, so now you have to make this hexagon. Okay, so now this is F is the A only, so we'll say this is dash, so we'll write this is A dash, this is a B dash, this is a C dash, and this is a D dash. Okay, so now make the original pentagon now little bit thin. Okay, so the second hexagon which you have taken the projection should be dark. Okay, so this is how exactly it is visible now. So now take a 45 degree line in front of the top view. This is a 45 degree. Now take the projections down. Okay, so this E will remain here, F will remain here, so A will be here. Okay, so B will be on this line, so C and the D and E and F. So now just make this one. This is how exactly we can do the problem. Okay, so this is a typical one. If not, what we can do, so normal way. Okay, so we can take a xy line. So let me do it here. We'll write a take a xy line. So we'll take the hexagon resting on the side like this. Okay, we'll write the naming A B C D EF, and we'll project this one up. We'll write here A dash, B dash, so F dash, C dash, and E dash and D dash. Okay, we'll make this dark. Now we'll take a 60 degree line. We'll cut this arc, make this dark one. We'll write the naming. We'll drop everything here, and again, once again, we'll get one more hexagon here. Okay, now take this resting edge and drop it here. Okay, this AB. This AB should be here, like this. Okay, again, if you project here, you will get a one more hexagon. So here also, this is A dash, B dash. So one of the side touches both the reference plane. So this is a normal method. Okay, hexagon, project upward, resting on the side. So inclined at 60 degree. Okay, and one of the side, that is the resting side, will touch the both the reference plane. Okay, if not, you can do in this way also. Okay, how? First take a one hexagon resting on the xy line. Okay, name it. Take a x1 y1, take the projection till x1 y1, take a 60 degree line, drop this with the arc, taking this as a intersection point as a reference, then take these projections backward. Okay, backward, and drop the vertical projection and make that hexagon dark. Okay, once it is done, you take the 45 degree in front of the top view and take the projection to the left side and complete. Okay, so this is the problem number 34. Okay, so there is a problem number 35. Okay, just I will give an int here so that you can solve that one. Okay, so what it says, same, a regular hexagonal lamina 30 mm side in such a way that one of its side touches both the reference plane. Same, 34 touches both the reference plane. If the side opposite to the side on which it rests is a 45 mm above HP. So here they gave an angle 60 degree directly, but here they are telling it is a 45 mm above. So what you can do here, so here, okay, so in a normal way, so here they are not given inclination, but here you can take a 30 mm line. Okay, yeah, sorry, it's a 45 mm. So take a 45 mm line, just drop one horizontal line, taking this reference, cut an arc and project it downward. Okay, so if you go with this method, here they have not given the angle, so you can measure 45 mm here. Okay, just I will show here, take a 45 mm line. Okay, just drop it like this. Okay, so now once this one is done, okay, so this as a reference, okay, from here, okay, just take and cut an arc like this. Okay, and you just take this line, will come here itself, you just extend, it will come here itself, same 60 degree, it is given in the reverse order. So once it cuts here, you just make that one dark and you take the arcs and complete it. Okay, just you need to take this line as a 45 mm.